It's 9:22. You're going to meet Joseph Garner right now. Now, here's what Joseph spent a month on the road and turned it into a documentary called Craigslist Joe, and here's what it's about.
With no money, no contact with anyone I know, I'm going to live entirely off Craigslist.
And just seeing if I could A, survive, like if I could literally eat, find shelter, find showers,
and B, try to travel America, see if I could find a community out there.
For the next month, this is all I got. So away we go.
My name is Joey. I saw the ad on Craigslist.
Well, Joe's here this morning because he wanted a free bagel.
Exactly.
We had that advertisement on Craigslist.
I saw it on Craigslist, exactly.
Good morning to you. The idea, the germination for this came from where?
I was actually working on another movie in Las Vegas a couple years ago.
A little one called The Hangover.
Exactly. Yeah. A little independent.
Yeah, no one's heard of that.
Nobody's heard of it. And this was actually kind of at the start of the recession, and I was pretty isolated from what was going on in the rest of the country. I'd come back home from work, turn on the news, and see, you know, devastating reports of people kind of losing their homes and life savings. So I got to thinking, you know, what would happen if that happened to me and I didn't have anyone I could turn to? Are we at a place in our society with technology where we have the potential to take care of one another?
Which is a wonderful social experiment. You were an assistant to Todd Phillips on that film, and here you are. People have got to wonder, huge advertisement for Craigslist. Are they paying you? Did they pay you? Did they help finance the film in any way?
No, they didn't know I was even doing this at the time. Like, I didn't even...
They like you now.
They do, but they're not like, they have no advertisements and they don't really promote anything.
Sure.
But I've met Craig Newmark, the founder. I've met Jim Buckmaster, the new CEO.
Did you ask them for a dollar or something?
No.
A sandwich?
No money was exchanged.
Do they want any money if the film does well?
No, I think we got the license agreement. And
all right, so part of this is the test of the generosity of people.
Yes.
So the first thing you put out was what?
My first ad, because no one knew I was doing a documentary, so I just wanted to be a regular guy looking to meet up.
Mm-hmm.
So I just said, hey, anyone looking to go on a hike today? And that spent about 6 hours trying to find nobody wanted to go on a hike.
And you started right here in LA.
Yeah,
right?
I walked to a park. I had a wireless internet card for my laptop. I got a new cell phone number prepaid for the month with a new phone number that none of my friends had.
Okay.
Because I didn't want to contact anyone I already knew. I just wanted to make new connections with people on the internet.
So nobody showed up.
Nobody showed up. My battery was about to die, so I went to went to this coffee shop, plugged in, still hadn't eaten anything all day. Then I put an ad out, looking for a meal or a place to stay. I'd be willing to do your house chores, do your laundry, paint your room.
Huh.
Some guy was intrigued and said, something about your ad caught my eye. It seems a little random, but why don't we meet up at a coffee shop and I'll see what you're all about.
So that was the beginning.
That was the very
first many, guy. I know I'm jumping way ahead here. How many interactions, positive interactions did you have?
I mean, hundreds.
What was your biggest score?
Biggest score, I'd say just being able to travel the country, meeting incredible people. I was able to do a lot of volunteer work in New York, which is.
Did you ask for a lot of things?
No.
No.
I like by the time I was back in LA, I had maybe a couple more T-shirts and an extra apple that I hadn't finished.
Did people put you up overnight?
Yeah, I would like find people that'd be willing to let me, you know, sleep on a couch or
slept
a floor.
In a van.
What
about the people in LA through this experiment?
Yeah.
Did you learn?
I felt like LA, at least for myself. Before I did this, I was kind of in my routine.
Sure.
How often do we like go to strangers and say, "Hey, do you want to hang out? Have a cup of coffee."
Like, we're a car city. We're always,
yes,
it's not like New York,
exactly,
where you're interacting
also,
with people.
It's also call the police.
So it was very difficult. LA was a challenging city in that respect. People are down here doing their thing. Like you mentioned, there's not a great, you know, public transportation option, and people are kind of going where they're trying to go. I was able to finally connect with some people in LA. I met this really interesting musician who put an ad up looking for someone to jam with. It was like 2 a.m. and we went up to this like used car dealership. I think he was like squatting above in one of the offices above. We ended up sleeping there that night.
What did you play?
I played bass guitar.
And he played?
He sang and played some guitar.
And when's the first record dropping?
Hopefully very soon.
Did I say record? Excuse me. Forgive me.
Eight-track is what you meant to say.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Boom!
Hey, it's day three. I had to get one.
Most generous thing that happened?
Most generous thing. I'd have to say, in LA, one of the most generous things, I met this high school kid, Matthew. Mm-hmm. I put an ad out looking for an extra set of wheels, a car, a bike, a pogo stick, anything to help me get around just because it was so far, you know, just I was walking.
Right.
And he saw my ad and said, I have an extra bike you're welcome to use. He called me 2 days later. I said, oh, you want my bike back? He's like, no, I just want to know where you're at. He came and brought a bag of apples.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah. Nothing in return.
So given, I mean, you know, you were shooting a movie in Vegas. It was, you know, a different kind of a place and a different kind of business.
Yeah.
Were you impressed by the fact that people were as kind and as generous as they were?
I was. You know, I always believe, like, people are good. You know, there's mm-hmm. obviously exceptions to that. There's, you know, especially online interactions. You got to be careful about that. But I was just – the thing that surprised me the most is that people were willing to reach out. Again, they didn't know I was doing a documentary. I was just a guy looking to meet up if there was yeah. going around town.
Where can we see this documentary?
It's actually opening today in Los Angeles at the Lemley – and mm-hmm. it's going to be playing there for a week.
So if I go on Craigslist and ask somebody to give me a free ticket, do you think I'll get one?
Absolutely. I'll give you a free ticket.
Oh, there you go.
Joe Gardner, thank you.
Thanks for having me on.
Good luck with the film.
Thank you.